Look at the traditional way of adding new fonts into your system from where the MS Word pulls it up. So my go-to website to download fonts is always fonts.google.com. I'll leave this link in the description. So let's find a font that is not existing in the system or MS Word. So there is a font called Poppins. Let's try that. It's not available in this. Nope. Let's click on Poppins. Download family. Once you download, it would probably be in your downloads folder. And once you extract that, you've got all the fonts here. You have downloaded the full Poppins family. Let's say I would like to add just this one, Poppins Black. First place that you need to go to is your control panel. Find fonts. And here is where this lists the fonts that are already in the system. This is the place from where your MS Word pulls all these fonts. Yeah. So we need to add the downloaded font here. All you need to do is drag it and drop it here. Once you do that, it installs it automatically. Once done, let's check whether it's available right here. Yep, you've got Poppins Black. You can close this now. You might want to close your font-based applications. We'll come back to that and let's go. Let's check whether we've got Poppins now. And let's search in P. Right there, you've got the new font. Yeah, Poppins Black. So this is the way you can traditionally add a font. There's another way where you can just search for font here. You've got font settings. You can drop your new fonts right here. Drag and drop to install. So once you drop your new font, it installs it. And you can use it not just in MS Word, but most of the default applications that comes along with your operating system. Sorry, this is not for iOS. That would be a different procedure altogether. But in a Windows operating system, this is the best way to add fonts. And always remember, your font types, the format of your fonts would either be in true type font file, also known as TTF, or they would be in open type. So these are the most popular ones, true type fonts and open type fonts. So these are the formats that indicate that a specific file is actually a font. Hope this adds value and has been helpful. Any questions? You've got the comment section. Thank you.